All right, so we have a fine opener. Cast Polykronos on turn 3. So Nylea is a fine card, an okay card, but really, it's not a card we want to have in our opening hand. It's not really the card we want to cast on turn 3. Okay, Mono Blue. This matchup, I think, is fine. Polykronos is just very, very good against them. The trick is playing it correctly, which can be pretty tricky. We have to play around Cyclonic Rift game 1, and then game 2 there's Rapid Hybridization. And then, of course, you want to know when to activate it in general, which usually you want to wait for Master of Waves. That's what I try to do. But like I said, it's very tricky. And we'll see exactly how we're going to use that soon, depending on what he does. Alright, well, see, that's a thing we want to kill right away, very likely. Oh, interesting. That's very interesting. So he wants to stunt my growth rather than stunt my attack for 5. I don't know, that's really weird. I'm trying to think of a reason why he would want to do that. If he has another Tidebinder Mage, that makes sense, kind of. Not a lot of sense, but a little bit of sense, yeah. Well, we drew Sylvan Caryatid, so our line is very simple here. We're gonna, you know, attack for 5, play the Caryatid for block. Let's see, right now we have 4 mana. Caryatid will bring us up to 5 plus 6 from the Nykthos. And then we have another land, so we don't really need that. Doing calculations with this deck can be pretty tricky. I usually just kind of do whatever. It usually works out. But there are situations where you do need to know exactly how much mana you're making at all times. This is probably one of those situations because we have to play around so many things. Okay, so he missed a point. That's cool. Nice of him. Alright, so he has... If he had a Master, he would not probably not play it yet. If he had a Thassa, though, he would have. Thassa right now is the card we don't really want to see. And he didn't have another Mage, either. Cyclonic Rift would make sense. So we have to try to play around that, I think. Let's see. So we're definitely not going to activate Polykronos yet. So then the question is, are we going to attack with him? We are able to block 2 power and take 5 plus whatever he wants to pump into the Frostburn. So if we assume he has Cyclonic Rift, then attacking gets kind of bad. Our hand is pretty good, so I think we're just going to... And then obviously we have Polychronos to use our mana later on, so I think we're just going to play for the long game. Okay, that's really tricky. If I'd played my Arbor Colossus first, I would have more information for whether or not I should keep this. But I think I should just keep this anyway. So I'm going to play my Colossus. Yeah, we don't need to be aggressive. We are probably going to win the late game. So in this situation, I could have played a Voyaging Satyr if I wanted to tap my Caryatid, but I didn't really want to. I don't know, though. That would put me pretty far ahead for next turn. Okay, so this is going to be interesting. He Rifted, and then he had Nykthos. And then he has Master Waves, wow. If he had the Nykthos in hand, he probably wouldn't have Cyclonic Rifted yet. So, probably drew that. But that doesn't really tell us anything. And then he played Master. I'm kind of... I really have no idea why he played Master here. I'm obviously gonna, you know, Polychronos it. I guess he wants to try to keep me off mana to recast Arbor Colossus. Yeah, I can't cast Colossus and use Polychronos. So, well, I have plenty of other options, you know, between the Domri, Nylea, and Voyaging Satyr. Okay, so if you play Domri, activate Nykthos, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 mana. We can play Colossus. We want to have 3 mana for this. And ideally, we want to have 3 mana for this and then another 3 to activate it in case he has a Cyclonic Rift. Which is unlikely because of the way he played this, but it's possible. So, I think we have to, you know, figure out how we're going to order this then. We have to have 6 mana when we activate Polychronos. So, playing Domri first is off the table. I think we can play Satyr. Satyr, activate. So, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Sakari Tid for backup. And then after this finishes resolving, then we can play Domri. Okay, so it works out perfectly. I probably should have played this last turn after all. I might have taken a few points, maybe. And I might not even have taken anything. And then I would have so much more mana this turn. We may not even want to play this Domri after all. Because now that we've used our Polychronos, we have no more removal except for the Domri. Though the Domri cannot deal with another Master. So, we'd be kind of cold to a Master. So maybe we just kill... We could kill Tidebinder Mage. That lowers his devotion. So another Master, we could try to beat it. The Cloudform Raptor we could kill, but we're going to be able to deal with that soon enough. I think giving ourselves like an absurd amount of mana and preventing a Master from being too good is our plan here. Okay. Good. I think, except for missing that Satyr, we play that game pretty well. And that could have been costly, actually. Could have been very costly. So for this matchup, I board all 4 Mortars, Hydras, and 2 Skylashers. And then I cut 2 Garruk. Garruk is fine, but you're more worried about the early game, I think. In the mid-late game, we are usually much better off. As long as they can't Cyclonic Rift everything. But for that reason, we cut Nylea. Nylea is just not very effective. And then I cut Tuskers and Oozes. Generally, I cut these against decks where they're not really necessary. Ooze specifically is only good against Mono Red, really. In general, it's fine, but our creatures are usually even bigger than Ooze can get, so we don't need it, except for Mono Red.